What's going on, everybody? It's Sasha, your market expert here in Charlotte. I hope you all are doing well. Welcome back to the channel. Happy New Year. I'm extremely excited to see where this real estate market is going to take us this year. Although I will give you a spoiler alert, I don't see too much happening at the moment right now. Interest rates are going up. As of today, when I last checked, they were 3.44% for a 30-year fixed rate. So it's gone up, but relatively speaking, it's still extremely low. Once we get to the high threes, closer to 4%, then I think we're going to start to see some prices start to stagnate out. And well, the magnets aren't that strong, but as I was saying, the prices are going to start to stagnate out a little bit. Maybe this thing falling is a sign that the real estate market's going to fall. I don't know, but maybe we'll start to see some prices start to stagnate. But I will tell you that this rise in interest rate is definitely taking some buyers out of the picture, because as opposed to the last year and a half to 2 years, where people were able to afford a $450,000, $500,000 house at a 3.0 interest rate, at a 2.8 interest rate, now those same people that were able to afford those houses sitting at a 3.5% interest rate, they're unable to. Now they're having to go down in a lower price point. So that is what we're going to start to see. And real estate moves pretty slow, so we might see that starting to adjust in the next couple months. I'm not going to get into a rant here, even though I felt like one. But with that being said, we're going to talk about the market report for the month of December, even though it's January 1st right now. The reason we do that is because we want an entire month of data compiled together to have the most accurate information possible. And full disclosure, around this time in December, because of the holidays, a lot of new listings tend to go down. Pending sales tend to go down, but we'll see what happened this month. Don't forget to like, hit the comment button, hit the subscribe button. And if there's anything I could ever do for you, any questions you might have, if you want a copy of any of this information, call, text, or email me anytime. And with that being said, let's get started with new listings. All right, so in regards to new listings, we have 3,462 new listings in the month of December. That's a 0.7% decrease from this time last year. And it's also just about 1,100 less new listings than we had in the month of November. So as I mentioned, this is very common, but that is a drastic drop of 1,100 less new listings than the month previous. Moving on to pending sales, we had 3,897 home sales pending. That's an 8.3% increase from this time last year. And it's roughly about 650 less home sales pending than we had in the month of November. But as you can see, based off the pending sales, we're up 8.3% from this time last year. So buyers are still buying up all these properties, and our supply has not met the demand for all the buyers that we have in the market right now. All right, now we're getting into the average sales price and the median sales price. So for the average sales price in the month of December, it was $410,000. That is a 17.1% increase from this time last year. And if we're comparing the average sales price to the month previous of November, it has gone up by about $4,000. In regards to the median sales price, which came in at $350,000, and that's a 20% increase from this time last year. And it's also a $2,000 decrease from the month previous. Guys, this median sales price is extremely important to pay attention to, especially if you're a buyer in this market. Based off the median sales price, you wanna have, at a minimum, when you're looking to buy a home, you wanna be in that $350,000 price range. Yes, you can buy houses for cheaper, but in order to prepare yourself to get into this market, to find a house in a good area, good location, good schools, and hit all the check boxes you're looking for, you're gonna be looking at a minimum of $350,000. And even at that $350,000 price point, it's not gonna be easy. You're most likely gonna be leaning towards $400,000, depending on the demand of the property and if you need to, you know, increase your bid due to multiple offers. So pay attention to this median price point. It's still relatively low when comparing it to other major cities, but we're starting to creep up there in close to the 400,000s as we're talking about median price point, which is starting to make me nervous. So these interest rates going up is going to be a good thing, because I'm hoping it's going to slightly drive these prices down a little bit to still have homes that are affordable in the Charlotte area. All right, now moving on to days on market, which came in at 20. So no change here from the month of November, which was also 20 days on market. This is a 23.1% decrease from this time last year, however. And just as a reference, if you didn't know, the more days on market, the better it is for buyers. The less days on market, the better it is for sellers. So make sure you keep that in mind. And if you are searching online on some of these real estate websites, if a house has been on the market for 20, 30 plus days or so, that gives you a lot more negotiating power when it comes to your offer and or negotiating repairs in the future when your offer does get accepted. Now let's get into the percentage of the original list price received, which was 100.2, and that's a 1.3% increase from this time last year. However, this, just like days on market, is no change. It's the same as it was in November. Now, this is kind of a boring stat for most people, but this is also very important to pay attention to. But based off of this number, on average, it's telling you that you can expect to pay 0.2% over the listed price for the home. Now, in all reality, this is really not accurate with what I'm seeing. It's almost a hit or miss. Most of the time, either the property sits on the market for a while and you have some negotiation where you can get a couple thousand dollars off maybe, or the other side of the coin, the house comes on the market and there's multiple offers and there's a ton of interest, which you're going 15, 20, 30 plus thousand dollars over the listed price based off the price range that you're looking at. You know, houses that are priced lower, you're not going to be offering $100,000 more. But if you're looking at a $1 million house, you might be offering $100,000 plus on top of that offer if it is a multiple offer situation. But this is important to pay attention to, because if we do get to a point where it's 90% of the purchase price, then that means you have a lot of negotiating power if there's not a ton of interest on the property when it first hits the market. All right, we know what time it is. Last but not least, months of inventory, which came in at 0.6, and that's a 45.5% decrease from this time last year. This number is depressing. I don't know where we're going to get inventory from. Let's see what starts to happen. In my opinion, the supply has not met the demand that we have for all these houses right now. And I don't really see any of this changing anytime soon, but we never know what can happen. Make sure you hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, leave me a comment. And as always, call, text, or email me if there's anything I can do for you. I'll catch you on the next one. Take care. Bye.